borders and in front of the raging shop.
They do it better the second time, yeah, so, because they've got it practiced, don't they? All the bottles coming out.
Ladies and gentlemen, this is Florence Fontaine's, and was there, as you can see, in many cases, by the Germans. And the, as you can see, they came forward with their Christmas trees, and they had them set out in thousands to the front there. Hang on, have they got some wine there as well? Yes, they also shed some wine, another mementos. They like to be a bit cautious at first, because, in fact, there was a chance for the men to realise that these were human beings as well. In fact, one of the fellows said, they wasn't a horrible monster hunter that we fought. You know, the sort of spine families. Many of them was just like us young lads, looking like they were missing home, their mothers and sweethearts. In fact, many Germans worked in England before the war. So when we took the boat and lived in cities, it wasn't a surprise to come across quite a few Germans. Hello, what's he got there? Oh, he's got a football. He's going to have a kick about now. Yes, it's true that there was, of course, the well-known fact that soldiers played football with their enemies. There were certainly some kickabouts, as you can see here. Some better than others, but not quite the built-up and glorified World Cup tie matches that were supposed to have happened. Ladies and gentlemen, for those of you that know, we had to wait until 1966 for that kind of battle. So there they are, going, yeah. Kickabout with it. See, they noticed that some of the English don't have... They don't have helmets, they weren't issued until later. We're looking at that there. It also gave them a chance, whilst they're out in the front in no man's land, to bury some bodies that have been out there since October.
Not the German footwork.
Quite a few reasons why they could stop.
That's gone up.
Oh, I'll say it, yeah.
But some of the generals were not pleased with this kind of behaviour.
Who this bloke here?
In fact, General Horace Smith Dorian, commander of the Devon Corps, said, we hear stories coming from the trenches about fraternising with the Germans. I therefore intend to issue instructions to my corps not to fraternise in any way whatever with the enemy.
Thank you.